find to be astonishing. The title of this video here kind of really needed some punctuation, as I think is going to become evident. I speak to a lot of members of the public about their experiences with hypnotherapists, and I speak to, you know, a lot of students who attend my classes and feed back to me about the types of hypnosis experiences that they've had prior to training to be a hypnotherapist. And likewise, I speak to a great many people who simply attend my one-day classes for personal development, who talk to me about their experiences in hypnotherapy sessions with hypnotherapists. And so many people describe the hypnotherapy sessions that they had as nice, or pleasant, or relaxing. Many hypnotherapists are therefore missing a trick, in my opinion. You see, when someone comes to see a hypnotherapist, they're highly receptive, they have expectancy, and usually they're primed and ready to be astonished. And that's what I think develops your business really impressively: astonishment. You want to make it your intention to wow those that come into contact with you as a hypnotherapist, or as a hypnosis professional in general. You know, every time you engage with someone in relation to your hypnotherapy business, you want to serve them in such a way that they are astonished. Help them and support them in ways, you know, that they're unlikely to be experiencing elsewhere or with the masses. Set yourself apart from the other hypnotherapists that your clients and potential clients are contacting or having experiences with. You know, in your hypnotherapy sessions, when a client leaves you, what do you think they're going to tell their spouse about their session with you, or their work colleagues or their friends the next day? You know, what are they going to tell colleagues, friends, confidants, or others that have similar issues that you could help with? You know, the better salespeople for your business are clients that had success with you, right? Yet the best salespeople for your business are clients who had success and who you served so well that they had astonishing experiences with you in your hypnotherapy rooms. Those are going to be the people planting their flag in the ground beside you. And there are so many ways to astonish your hypnotherapy clients, and that's what this video is about, you know, just a brief idea. Firstly, I think appropriate humor. When I talk about using humor in hypnotherapy sessions, you know, I don't mean that you tell gags, you know, "Hello, Mrs. Smith, nice to meet you, I'm Adam. Anyway, knock, knock." Or you know, "Hello, Mr. Smith, I hope you're well, you know, your mama's so fat." You know, these are probably not the most appropriate opening gambits for developing an effective or professional working alliance with your client. That's not what I'm referring to here. Being able to find joy, humor, and laughter in some of the seemingly dark places that exist in a hypnotherapy session can be illuminating, you know, on a number of different levels. A bit like shining a torch in. It can break down barriers, it can ease pain, it can build relationships, and it can heal. When people laugh and have fun, sessions with a hypnotherapist start to become memorable for a wide number of very good reasons. Anecdotes, stories, metaphors can of course be heavily punctuated with good humor. A hypnotherapist, you know, effectively using self-deprecating humor, for example, can help develop rapport, the working alliance. It's rare for people to associate therapy sessions with fun and laughter and joy, because we're so often working with very serious issues. And I'm not suggesting that we belittle those issues and we don't attempt anything that's inappropriate or unprofessional. Yet striking the right notes with humor gives clients a wonderful experience that they will speak fondly of. I mean, second of all, as well as humor, you know, we have language. I mean, as talk therapists, as hypnotherapists, language is pivotal. Using language in a way that enlivens the session, that makes it enjoyable, exciting, and fun. That doesn't mean that we have to use jargon or great big long multi-syllabic words that baffle. It means that we want to bring the session to life, to be appropriately emotive with the voice and with language, while also remaining congruent with who you are. You know, we want our language to motivate and to inspire and help the client feel safe, secure, and in good hands. Thirdly, we have hypnotic phenomena. You know, a main tool for astonishment that hypnotherapists have over and beyond that which other talk therapies can offer. The very use of hypnosis, you know. I recall working with a man that had been to see another hypnotherapist prior to me. And at his first session with me, he described the session that he'd experienced. He said, you know, it was very nice. He was very nice. I was very relaxed, but I'm still not sure I was hypnotized. I think, you know, if you are a hypnotherapist, surely it's you know, or at least part of your raison d'etre is to ensure people know they have been hypnotized and have experienced it convincingly, you know, unwavering arm catalepsy, hand stuck to the table, incredible arm levitation, amnesia, anesthesia, or plain simply getting a pen stuck to the hand and testing it, you know, urging them to test it and not attempt to comply or just try and please me, you know, the hypnotherapist. That, you know, hypnotic phenomena also becomes, you know, hypnotic skills for the client to practice and develop. And it becomes a great way for you to effectively conceptualize how hypnosis works and to give evidence of the best, the best way to develop responsiveness. But importantly, they will know that they've been hypnotized. They'll know it. You know, how did the session go with the hypnotherapist, darling? You know, compare the answer of, it was nice, you know, the hypnotherapist really relaxed me, played pleasant whale music, and I think I nodded off. Not sure if I was hypnotized, kind of thing. You know, you could compare that kind of response with, you know, it was amazing. My hand was stuck to the table. I couldn't get it off. There was no glue involved either, you know, and was just kind of certain and convinced that hypnosis had happened. You see, when people go to see a hypnotherapist, then, you know, that they want hypnosis, they're expecting it. Use hypnosis to astonish them and deliver upon, you know, those high expectations. And your sessions will stand out greatly from those of the majority of other, you know, provincial hypnotherapists. And your client's going to be talking about their experiences with you before they've even achieved the therapy results, which, of course, you know, will be wonderful for them to discuss and talk about and make reference to. I think also, you know, your education. You can dazzle people by demonstrating a depth of knowledge, you know, having credibility when it comes to your subject, helping educate them effectively with the right kind of knowledge. Evidence suggests that when people understand, you know, the underpinning rationale about hypnosis, they'll become more responsive. When they're more responsive and have a better understanding and the subject is demystified, then it could be something that they can do for themselves and they can share with others, you know. I think serving people, you know, astonishing through service, giving people amazing experiences of you, demonstrating your skills, be outstanding at what you do, you know, get the best hypnotherapy training for starters, you know, I have bias on that one. And then when you have one-to-one encounters and consultations and conversations and interactions, you do whatever you possibly can to serve them and to serve them wonderfully well, you know, over-deliver on what they expect too, give better service, give more resources and go on to astonish people with the way you serve them and with the actions you take to help them and to support them. These points that I've spoken about here, you know, that quite briefly, you know, that they're at the foundation of every hypnotherapy session that I have with clients and that I teach people to embody, and at the heart, you know, of what I teach here at my college and our ethos. Setting out to astonish your clients is one of the best things you can do on a commercial level, you know, for your hypnotherapy business. And that's what, you know, this kind of small video was attempting to be all about and to imprint upon you. If you do these things well, you know, you'll easily thrive as a hypnotherapist. You don't need all the gimmicks and all the nonsense that's sold out there about how to develop your business. You know, don't give people just nice experiences with you as a hypnotherapist. Serve them so well. Make them laugh appropriately. Educate them. Use inspiring language. Elicit hypnotic phenomena, and you will astonish them. And the more people you astonish when you encounter them, the better your hypnotherapy business will develop. That's it. You know, do subscribe to this channel. Go visit my college website, explore our classroom-based and online range of courses in the hypnosis and hypnotherapy field, much of which will help help you to learn how to truly astonish people in this field. I send you my very best wishes. Goodbye for now.